Today we are going to introduce you how to connect our multi-apartment intercom system. First of all, here is what we will need. Qualified cable 568B, the standard. And RJ45 connector switch. And a flush mount box. This is the outdoor unit. Each unit comes with their accessory. We have a indoor monitor. Two kinds of power supply. One is 12 DC voltage. The other is 32 DC voltage. This is 12 voltage. And now we begin. Oh, also the module. This one goes to the lock, the power E-lock, and this goes to DC 12 voltage. The lock, and DC 12 voltage. Once the power is on, you will hear a beep on the outdoor unit. And then we connect it to the module. Connect it here, input. The output, the P out is for another module. If you have more apartments, if you have more than four apartments, and now we connect the indoor monitor. So everything is ready. Now, yeah. And you also need a power here, 12 voltage and 32 voltage. This one is DC 32 voltage. This is DC 12 voltage. You can see the light is on the indoor monitor. Now we are going to set room number on the outdoor unit. For example, if we want to set 0002 on this indoor monitor, here we are. We push the unlock button. We push the unlock button and this emergency button. Sorry. Once the programming is successful, it will hit a long beep. Means the setting is successful, is complete. And we double click on this button to exit the programming status. Now I will dial a room number. If you push this button, the lock will be open, will be released. The house owner can open the door by this blue token card. Here I will show you how to resist this card. Again, the same combination password to enter the programming status. For example, I want to resist the card for this family. Their room number is 002. And with we exist by double pushing. Now I'm going to open the door, open the lock by this blue token card. Listen carefully. You will hear the a sound from the lock. It means the door is opened. Also, the lock, the time for opening the lock can be adjusted on the panel. And we are going to set room number for this monitor. Now we push a combination of passwords, the same passwords. Once you are in the program state, you will hear a long beep. Now I'm going to set 001 for this monitor. Push call and help. Push call and help. Again, if the programming is successful, you will hear a long beep, both from the door panel and the indoor monitor. Now we double push this button to exit the programming stator. Now I will dial 001 to call this indoor monitor. What if you have got more than 4 apartments? Then you will be needing another module. POUT. We connect it to next module. Input. See input here. And similarly, you need a 12 voltage and 32 voltage. And this is 32. Oh, sorry, this is 32, this is 12.
Let's see, you can't do it.
And this is 32. Previously, we set a room number 002 for this indoor monitor. On this monitor, the touch screen panel, you can check the record of the visitor, check who is calling, for example. If the house owner didn't answer the phone call, you see there is a visitor records. See? You can see who is calling. This is the picture memory function.